my goodness. Nobody wants to end that song. Gosh. Wow. 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 Thank you, Alabama! That's right. You got it. I love it. I love it. Y'all, first and foremost, I want to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Number one. Without him, nothing is possible. This morning, I was reading the scripture that you gave me, Jamie, and this morning's was Romans 8:28. And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. Last night when you said the prayer, Uncle Mike, you said they answered the call. They may not have wanted to, but they answered his call. When I read more about the scripture, it said every single thing, the hard stuff, the heartbreaks, the hurdles, he uses it all for your healing. Everything is in preparation for your purpose. No matter how it feels, trust that he is using it for your good. Faith is walking forward, trusting his character. Folks, amen to that. When we got in this race, nobody thought this was possible. I mean, unless you were related to me or in a very small circle, you didn't think that this could be done. As Wesley and I prayed about it and prayed about it and prayed about it some more, we knew we were the underdog. And that actually may even be an understatement. We were told by pretty much everyone, everywhere, this was an insurmountable task and do not take it on. But ultimately, the two of us believe in this state. We believe in this nation and we believe both are worth fighting for. So as people said, you can't win. People said, this will be David versus Goliath. Do you not realize you're up against a sitting congressman who is polling above 60%. I responded with, well, I'm polling at 4. And that's right, you gotta start somewhere. I had a gentleman correct me and say, I don't mean to embarrass you, but I saw a poll and you're actually at 2. So I was told, you're too young, wait your turn. Oh, wait for this one, this is one of my favorites. You're from the wrong part of the state. Everybody knows I love being from the Wiregrass, so that just fired me on up. And the last one that I got a lot was, but you're a mom. And I will say that that is exactly what drove me off the sideline. I have said I am a mama on a mission. And the two reasons that Wesley and I chose to jump in this race are standing right beside us. We know they're worth fighting for. Your children, your grandchildren are worth fighting for. Alabama's future is worth fighting for, and this nation is worth fighting for. As our children reminded us early on, God calls us to do hard things. Well, I'll be honest with you, it still hasn't sunk in that we actually did a really hard thing. I will tell you this, though, tonight, me standing in front of you is proof that the American dream is alive. And we're running to preserve that for your children. I mean, that dream allowed this public school girl from the Wiregrass, the daughter of two small business owners who watched her parents work 6 and 7 days a week to make ends meet, someone who worked herself through college, got to law school, and had a newborn, two little ones, landed jobs I never dreamed I could have, and now standing before you as the Republican nominee for the United States Senate. One thing is clear, and that is Alabama has spoken. We want new blood. We want fresh blood. We want someone who will fight for our Christian conservative values, who will fight for the freedoms and liberty this nation was founded on, and will fight for that American dream for the next generation and the next. I will say this, this campaign has never been about me. It has always been about you. And I am looking across this room, y'all, and I am blown away. I'm seeing people from Jackson County and Baldwin County and coworkers from Birmingham and everyone in between. Thank you for stepping up. Thank you for being here. Thank you for helping me in this journey. I will say this. We knew this was about the future of the state and the future of the nation. And so as Wesley and I drove across all 67 counties, and I like to say that Wesley ate his way through all 67, right? I told him he needs to write a book of all the great places to eat in Alabama. But as we have been through this incredible state, we have been moved by people's stories. It is the veterans that I sat with in East Deboga in Talladega County who told me their story. Look at that, I love it. Who told me their stories, not only of how they served our nation honorably, but the challenges that are in front of them today. It's about the children in Sumter County at University Charter School, who we know now have a path of hope and a future because of the investment that that community has chosen to make. Everything from the little ones to the high school seniors realize that no child zip code should determine their opportunity, and that school is helping make that a reality. It is for the parents, that's right. It is for the parents who have shared their tragedies with me, who have talked to me about their children committing suicide, who have talked to me about opioid overdoses, and have talked to me about unfortunately losing loved ones to fentanyl overdoses. Folks, it's to the retired gentleman who I met at the gas station in Chilton County, who said, I worked my whole life. I did everything they told me to. And now I'm having to pick up this job at night just to make ends meet. It is to the farmers, and I see you all out there. Thank you. Who have talked to me about overburdensome regulation and taxes and their fear of not being able to pass along the family farm to the next generation. This is for you. What I want you to know, all the incredible people that we have met across this state, you have shared with us your hopes, your dreams, your fears, your concerns, your challenges, and your opportunities. Too often we have politicians that come down and lecture us instead of listen. And what I want you to know is I hear you. And tonight, I think it is safe to say that America has heard Alabama too. And now the next step is to send Joe Biden a message in November. I am looking forward to working alongside my fellow Republican nominees across the country to retake the House and the Senate so we can once again put America first. I'd like to thank Congressman Brooks for his service and his commitment to that shared mission. He ran a hard-fought campaign, and I look forward to working hard to earn the support of his voters in November. And before I get to some much-deserved thank yous, I want to make sure you know a couple of things. One, I love this state. I believe in this state. We have incredible people, and we have a wonderful story to tell. I am honored that you would allow me to be a part of telling that story. As your next United States Senator, I will work tirelessly to grow 21st century opportunity for all Alabamians, regardless of their zip code. That is what the American dream is all about. I promise you, I will work nonstop to defend our values and to defend our people. And speaking of, there are a lot of people who made tonight possible. Oh my gosh, it's all my nieces and nephews. I was wondering who was giving me some feedback right here. It's leave it up to family to keep it real with you.
And you have a cousin.
And a cousin, that's right. Speaking of, my family, I'm gonna start with that first. Wesley, Bennett, Ridgway, and my parents. They have all sacrificed a great deal this year. Wesley, as many of you know, and I'm gonna say this because I realized last time when we were up here that the people at home didn't get to see Wesley's head. So for those of you who are watching, he is the gentleman right above the line here. So they said, you have such a nice backdrop. I'm like, did the flags look great? They were like, no, it was just Wesley's chest. So, you know. But Wesley resigned from his job for us to do this. And you all know that is never in the financial plan at 40 years old. But he is the rock of our family. And he has been with us step by step by step. Wesley, Britt, I couldn't do this without you. I am so... I am so proud you chose me to be your wife, and I am just so grateful for you. Kids, these two right here, Ridgway, Bennett, come here. They have literally grown so much this year. At the beginning of the campaign, they were here, and now they've moved to here. But literally and figuratively, you have shown such grace and strength. We all remember what middle school was like, and you add this additional layer onto it. I am so proud that you remain grounded in your faith and your love for this country, and that you're willing to step up and help us in this endeavor. We love you. So to my parents who have done everything, filled all the gaps, Yaya, everybody in here knows Yaya at this point. Yaya and Papa, we couldn't have done it without you. I know as a parent, one of the greatest challenges is watching your children struggle, watching them be in unfortunate situations, and boy, have you had to do that this year. I am so grateful. I am so grateful for the foundation you laid with me, that of faith, and the tools that you gave me, those tools that you equipped me with growing up, making me work at 6 and 7 years old and moving on, they're the exact tools that got me through this last year, and I'm so grateful for the two of you. I love you. So, all right, so God blessed me with an incredible family, incredible in-laws. I see them all back here, cousins, aunts, uncles, everyone, thank you. Y'all stepped up, answered the call no matter what it is that we needed on both sides of the family. We are so grateful for you, and thank you for supporting me at every turn. And last, my sisters, where are they? Oh, there they are. There they are. Y'all, life, God really blessed me to let me do life with my best friends. We have four girls, and everybody always asks, boy, I bet y'all don't get along. And I'm like, oh, no, we do. We do. You have supported me at every turn, and I couldn't have done this without you. I love y'all. So, all right. So, friends, from preschool to high school to college to law school, to travel sports, family, you know, as you get an adult, that ends up taking up your life, your kids travel sports, to my walking group, to everyone that I am fortunate enough to call a friend. Y'all have such a special place in my heart. Whether it was encouraging me with texts, prayers, helping shuttle the children around, or putting together meet and greets, y'all have stepped up in such meaningful ways. Wesley said it best when he said, Katie, it's gotta make you proud that the people who know you the best are your biggest supporters. To our county captains and amazing team of grassroots volunteers, this wouldn't have happened without you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Y'all, we ran an old school grassroots campaign, and it is all of you, it is the county captains, it is the volunteers that made this possible. To our campaign staff and our field team, y'all are the best. You know, you are only as good as those around you, and I am fortunate to be surrounded by the best. And when it comes to that campaign team, y'all were some of the very few who said, yeah, it's possible, and we're gonna do it, and we're gonna stand in there with you. I am so grateful, and this would not have happened without y'all. Our trade associations and coalitions, thank you for making sure that your members and your people got intimately involved in this, that we had people telling people telling people, and we utilized every avenue to get our message out. To Senator Shelby and Dr. Shelby, who gave this college student a chance, you took a shot on me. That shot, that opportunity, changed what was possible for me. And for that, Senator, I will always be grateful. What an honor and privilege to be able to learn under one of the very best. My career path has led me from working with Senator Shelby to Dr. Witt, to my family at the Business Council in Butler Snow. It is those individuals that invested in me, who taught me about teamwork, who taught me to step up and answer the call. I am so proud to be your colleague. I am so proud to have learned from you, to be able to grow with you. And thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm trying to find all of you out there. Thank you for standing in there with me. All right, and wrapping it up from our early supporters, like Senator Shelby, Senator Deb Fisher was the very first one. She said, you know what, I'm with you. We need more people like you in the US Senate. And that was that. Then incredible people who came in and endorsed us in the runoff, Senator Cotton, Ernst, and my friend Sarah Huckabee Sanders, and so many more. To, of course, President Trump, helping us wrap this thing up in style. People across Alabama miss his America First agenda, and we are going to go to the United States Senate to fight for it each and every day. Thank you. And to all of you, whether you Girl Staters, DYW, hardworking people, people from my hometown that I see out there that drove all the way here, I am so grateful. Thank you. There are so many people who were critical parts of making this happen. And to countless Alabamians and Americans who prayed for us, offered us encouragement, expressed your confidence and belief in us, it means more than you could ever imagine. My family and I will be forever grateful. We chose to run an old school campaign, visiting all 67 counties. And there is someone who wasn't able to be with us tonight. He passed away in the midst of all of this, but that was his vision. We love him and missed him, our friend Palmer Hamilton. He had such a vision and passion that we could achieve this. I know he's celebrating with us in this very moment. So guys, I will conclude tonight by saying I am blown away by this crowd. I am blown away by this energy. We knew that this movement was growing, but tonight, this is proof of that. I will say this, I promise you nobody will work harder in the United States Senate. I will work tirelessly every day to make Alabama proud. As Garland said, Alabama's future is bright. God bless you, God bless the great state of Alabama, and God bless the United States of America.